Solution to a 4-mark question that appeared from the topic statistics. It's an easy question, question number 40. We'll do the solution to this question and we'll follow it up with one extra bonus question that you guys can try yourself. Let's get started with this question. The following distribution gives a daily income of 50 workers of a factory. Income has been given in 5 class intervals and the number of workers in each class interval is given. We need to do two things. One, convert this distribution to a less than type of cumulative frequency distribution. And two, draw its ogive. Do one thing, the next slide, we'll just get started with the process and understand what we are doing. And I'll also in a slide present to you how you need to be doing this. One is to learn, second is to how we write it in the examination. Let's get started with the slide. This is the learning slide, right? This is the data given to us. The class intervals, 5 different income intervals, and then the number of workers in each of these things. What we'll have to draw is a less than type cumulative frequency. So what we are going to do is, we're going to pick the upper end of each of these class intervals and write it down here. So daily income less than 420, less than 440, less than 460, less than 480, less than 500. How many people earn less than 420? Anyone in the 400 to 420 is going to be earning less than 420. So this is going to be the frequency of the first class interval. Let's move on to the second one. Here we're checking to find out how many employees earn less than 440. Those who earn 400 to 420 plus those who earn 420 to 440, the sum of these two values is going to give us that. So 26 employees earn less than 440. We realize that all we have to do is basically add this 14 to the cumulative frequency at the preceding step. We would have got this 26. Let's run through this for less than 460. All of these three class intervals are people who earn less than 460. So what would we have done? We would have done 12 plus 14 plus 8, which is 26 plus 8, which is equal to 34. Alternatively, add this 8 to this 26 and write it down here, which is equal to 34. How many earn less than 480, which is 34 plus 6, which is equal to 40. And how many earn less than 500, that's 40 plus 10, which is equal to 50, right? Look at the stage. How many earn less than 480? All of these four class intervals will come into it. So 26, 34, 40. How many earn less than 500? Everyone here is earning less than 500. So all 50 will come right now into this. So this gives us the cumulative frequency distribution. This is the idea behind it. How do you have to present it at the examination? The next slide will tell us. So this is all that you need to do. Daily income less than and write down the values of the upper end of each of these class intervals. And then write the number of workers in each class interval and write the cumulative value. Cumulative value is the first one is the same as this frequency. The second one is 12 plus 14 equals 26. 26 plus 8 is 34. 34 plus 6 is 40. 40 plus 10 is equal to 50. So step one of drawing this cumulative frequency distribution is done. Step 2, we need to draw this ogive. Ogive is nothing but drawing a graph which has got an x-axis and a y-axis. What is in the x-axis? In the x-axis, we are going to be basically plotting this upper end of each of the class intervals. What is the y-axis? Y-axis is going to be the cumulative frequency of this entire income distribution. So to plot it, we'll essentially have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. What are the coordinates of the point? For the first point, the coordinate is going to be, the x coordinate is 420, the y coordinate is 12, the cumulative frequency. For the second point, the coordinate x coordinate is a 440, 26 is the cumulative frequency at this point, so we take 26. For the third point, it is 460 is the x coordinate, 34. Fourth one is 480, 40, and the last one is 500, 50. So basically, take a graph, plot these points, join them, and that's essentially what is the less than ogive, right? Here is the value. X-axis is the daily income, the upper end of each of the class intervals. Y-axis is the cumulative frequency. So these are the coordinates of the point. We join them. This gives us the less than ogive. As I mentioned, I'm going to give you a bonus question. Try this question. This is not a less than type. We'll have to find out the more than type for it. The following distribution gives the marks scored by 70 students of a class in a recently concluded test. Right. We have again 5 class intervals for their marks and the number of students in each other class interval. What you need to do is convert this distribution to a more than type of cumulative frequency distribution and draw its corresponding ogive. Check out what is the shape of the ogive. Is it the same as this or is it going to be something different? Best wishes. Before you leave, do two things. Sign up at online.maxtute.com for CBSE online coaching for Class 10 Maths. It takes less than 5 minutes in all of 3 steps to get started. And do one more thing. Subscribe to this channel, youtube.com/maxtute, and spread the word about this channel to your friends and classmates.